His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, in the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, received at Khir Palace the representatives, Council Speaker Ahmed Al Musallam, the Shura Council Chairman Ali Al Saleh, and Vice President of the Supreme Judicial Council and President of the Cassation Court, Sheikh Khalid bin Ali bin Abdullah Al Khalifa. They congratulated His Majesty on the anniversary of the National Action Charter, expressing their pride in the leadership of His Majesty and his wise approach. They praised the comprehensive achievements that the country made during the reign of His Majesty for the development of Bahrain, praying to Allah the Almighty to grant His Majesty with abundant health and happiness and perpetuate Bahrain with prosperity, security and stability under His leadership. His Majesty the King exchanged his congratulations to them, thanking them for their noble sentiments. His Majesty praised the various achievements made by the legislative authority in terms of developing laws and legislation that serve the aspirations of citizens, preserving the nation's gains, and highlighting its achievements in all forums, and the important role played by the judicial authority in promoting the principles of justice and equality, and preserving rights and freedoms. His Majesty praised the cooperation and coordination between the executive and legislative authorities to continue building on the gains achieved by the benefit of the kingdom and its people. His Majesty praised the kingdom's many achievements throughout its history, thanks to its solidarity of its people. He stressed that Bahrain's march continues on the path of progress towards a more prosperous future, thanking all the efforts and endeavors for the development of Bahrain. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, in the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, received at Khir Palace a number of senior royal family members to greet His Majesty on the occasion of the anniversary of the National Action Charter. The audience congratulated His Majesty on the occasion and expressed pride in the achievements of the kingdom and its people in all fields, which raised the kingdom's status globally thanks to the leadership of His Majesty the King and his wise approach. They prayed to Allah the Almighty to bless His Majesty with lasting good health and happiness to continue the march of development in his prosperous era. His Majesty welcomed the guests and congratulated them on the occasion and expressed thanks and appreciation for their noble sentiments.
سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المعظم حفظه الله ورعاه، سيدي صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد رئيس مجلس الوزراء حفظه الله ورعاه، أصحاب السمو أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، أيها الحضور الكريم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته، وكل عام وأنتم بخير. إنها مناسبة يحق لنا الاحتفال بذكراها، فميثاق العمل الوطني كما وصفتموه يا سيدي فتحاً جديداً في تاريخ البحرين، وهو كذلك، فقد وضع ميثاق العمل الوطني مبادئ سياسية واقتصادية واجتماعية من خلالها دخلت مملكة البحرين بفضل الله تعالى وبفضل فكركم النير أيدكم الله، دخلت عصرا جديدا من العمل الوطني الذي نشهده اليوم بما تحقق في مسيرة التنمية الشاملة. صاحب الجلالة، أيها الحضور الكريم، تلاوة عطرة من القرآن الكريم يتلوها على مسامعنا القارئ علي صلاح عمر.
After that recitation of verses from the Holy Quran were recited.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أفمن يعلم أنما أنزل إليك من ربك الحق كمن هو أعمى إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب الذين يوفون بعهد الله ولا ينقضون الميثاق والذين يصلون ما أمر الله به ويخشون ربهم ويخافون سوء الحساب والذين صبروا ابتغاء وجه ربهم وأقاموا الصلاة وأنفقوا مما رزقناهم سرا وعلانية ويدرؤون بالحسنة السيئة أولئك لهم عقبى الدار جنات عدن يدخلونها ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم والملائكة يدخلون عليهم من كل باب سلام عليكم بما صبرتم فنعم عقب الدار صدق الله العظيم.
قصيدة بمناسبة الاحتفال بذكرى ميثاق
العمل الوطني. Then Sheikh Ahmed bin Hamad bin Abdullah bin Muhammad Al Khalifa recited a poem on the occasion.
Ahmed bin Abdullah Al Khalifa.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. جلالة الملك المعظم مساك ربي بمزن الخير مدرار يخصك وعم الدار وأهل الدار وأذن لي يا طويل العمر بإلقاء القصيدة. باسم الأدب باسم الأدب هالفلك لجله وشرناه وانذر ردي الشعر مويل لطيمي وما الجزل من كل جوز حملناه نحميه عن سوء المآل الوخيمي ثم فار تنور البحر وارتفع ماه واحنا معاه وسط مويه نهيمي عليه من عنغارة النقص يبراه فرز الشدايد والمصاب الجسيمي طيب الأدب أمن على خير جزلاه احمى حمد عن كل شر أثيمي بمرحبة وأهلا وسهلا وحياه السنع في عهده يعيش النعيمي عذب النسب جزله على الطيب يمناه أصله إلى نبع الوايل سليمي نهر التغلب أنت سيده ومبناه سده دلتاه الخصيب المجيمي ترثة ربيعه انت عذقه ومجناه ومن الرمك اورثك حظ عظيمي الملك يزهى في ربيعه وشفناه فيكم عسى ربي الملكك يديمي خصك وصاغ المجد تاجك بيمناه وحداك يا حرز التراث الجديمي والعز من فعلك نزع عنه برداه والبسك يا غوث الضعيف اليتيمي غيثك بلغ ذبل التقاليد وحياه الجود لك لولاك لاصبح هشيمي ويوم العوايد يرت الصوت بالآه الوقت جرعها الغلي الحميمي محد النصرها من سموم المعاناة إلا أنت وأنتم في براد وغيمي بات النصر متبسم لك وأرضاه فعلك فأصبح لك ولي حميمي رحاك لي دارت على الضد تفناه وتحيل صلب الباس منه منعيمي شاهق فأذهلت المقالم والأفواه في مدحكم يتعب لسان الكليمي صح القصيد بفضل جودك وطرياه وشعر خلا ذكرك عويج سجيمي وسلامتك طويل العمر.
After that, Bahraini Arda was performed on the occasion.
Thank you.
His Majesty recalled the honorable patriotic stances of the Bahraini people, which came unanimously and embodied the Bahraini identity that aims to achieve civilizational advancement and development. His Majesty affirmed that the principles of National Action Charter will remain aimed to achieve further development and enhance the role of the legislative institutions and open up further opportunities for national participation in accordance with the democratic approach of the kingdom in a way that benefits the country and its people. His Majesty affirmed that the flag of Bahrain will remain high and an icon of advancement and development thanks to its loyal people. He wished Bahrain further security, stability, progress and prosperity in all fields. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa patronized the celebration of the Ministry of Education on the occasion of the anniversary of the National Action Charter at the National Action Charter Monument. Upon His Majesty's arrival, he was received by the Minister of Education, Dr. Muhammad bin Mubarak Jum'a, where His Majesty welcomed the students participating in the celebration.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المعظم، حفظكم الله ورعاكم. إننا هنا اليوم في صرح الميثاق الوطني، طلابا وطالبات، معلمين ومعلمات، مسؤولين ومسؤولات في وزارة التربية والتعليم، تملأنا مشاعر الفخر والاعتزاز، وتغمرنا الغبطة والسرور، ونحن نحتفل بذكرى ميثاق العمل الوطني الذي كان مفتتح المشروع الحضاري لجلالتكم، والشاهد على انطلاق مملكتنا الحبيبة إلى رحاب الإنجاز والتميز. وخير ما نبدأ به حفلنا هذا آيات عطرة من القرآن الكريم
يتلوها
على مسامعنا الطالب محمد مطيع سعيد من مدرسة الهداية الخليفية الثانوية للبنين.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله نور السماوات والأرض، مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح، المصباح في زجاجة، الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري يوقد من شجرة مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار، نور على نور، يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس، والله بكل شيء عليم. صدق الله العظيم.
حييت من ملك أقام لشعبه صرحا من الأقوال والأفعال، في كل ركن فيه تنبض قصة تروى بكل الفخر للأجيال. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة، إن النهضة التعليمية شهدت في العهد الزاهر لجلالتكم تطوراً كبيراً، وتشهد على ذلك التقارير الدولية والإنجازات التي حققها أبناؤكم وبناتكم الطلاب والطالبات في مختلف المحافل العلمية والتعليمية الدولية. والآن مع كلمة سعادة الدكتور محمد بن مبارك جمعة وزير التربية والتعليم بهذه المناسبة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
The Minister of Education congratulated His Majesty the King and His Royal Highness on the anniversary of the National Action Charter. During his speech, he stressed that the Ministry and its affiliates express his gratitude to His Majesty the King for the continued patronage received during the prosperous era of His Majesty for Education, who improved knowledge and education and strengthened the approach of investing in students. The minister pointed out that the ministry was keen on developing the educational system in line with the comprehensive development of His Majesty the King in a way that copes with international standards. He added that the ministry included the principles of divisions of the charter in school curricula for its importance in raising younger generation and enhancing the values of belonging, responsibility, human rights, tolerance, coexistence, dialogue, and national unity. He added that the ministry is focusing on teaching the history of the kingdom to instill the history and values in students, as well as enhancing the culture of voluntary work and the values of tolerance and coexistence. The minister said that the ministry provided quality educational services for its people, especially for people with special needs, which reflected positively on students and opened up wider opportunities.
موعدا مع التاريخ وسطر فيها أوضح معاني الولاء والتأييد لنهجكم الحكيم في بناء حاضر مملكة البحرين ومستقبلها، وأبرزت عمق العلاقات والتلاحم المتين بين القائد وشعبه. سيدي جلالة الملك المعظم حفظكم الله ورعاكم، إن الأسرة التعليمية الوفية لنهجكم الحكيم لتلهج بالشكر والثناء في هذا المقام السامي، وتعبر عن أسمى عبارات الامتنان والعرفان لجلالتكم حفظكم الله ورعاكم لما تحظى به من رعاية موصولة في عهدكم الزاهر الذي أعلى راية العلم والتعليم وعزز نهج الاستثمار في أبنائنا الطلبة الذين يمثلون الثروة الحقيقية التي ستعزز إنجازات الحاضر وتسهم في بناء مستقبل البحرين المشرق بإذن الله تعالى. وقد حرصت وزارة التربية والتعليم على تطوير المنظومة التعليمية والتربوية في إطار مسيرة التحديث والتنمية الشاملة بقيادة جلالتكم، مواكبة لأحدث التوجهات العالمية في تعزيز العلوم واقتصاد المعرفة والمهارات الرقمية. كما عملت الوزارة على تضمين المبادئ والرؤى السامية المستلهمة من ميثاق العمل الوطني في المناهج الدراسية، إيماناً منها بأهمية تربية النشأ على هذه المبادئ الوطنية والحضارية والإنسانية، وتعزيزاً لقيم المواطنة وروح الانتماء والمسؤولية وحقوق الإنسان والتسامح والتعايش والحوار والاعتدال والوحدة الوطنية من خلال المناهج الدراسية. وفي هذا الإطار تتوسع الوزارة في تطبيق منهج التربية للمواطنة لجميع المراحل الدراسية بما يتضمنه من قيم ومبادئ ترتكز على ثوابت ميثاق العمل الوطني. كما تتوسع الوزارة في تدريس تاريخ مملكة البحرين لترسخ في أذهان ووجدان الطلاب والطالبات عراقة هذا التاريخ الأصيل منذ فتح مملكة البحرين وتأسيسها دولة عربية مسلمة مستقلة على يد المؤسس أحمد الفاتح، فضلاً عن حضارة البحرين الممتدة لآلاف السنين. كما ركزت الوزارة من خلال مناهج ومساقات مستحدثة أخرى على تكريس هذه القيم الوطنية السامية على غرار مساق خدمة المجتمع الذي يرمي إلى ترسيخ ثقافة العمل التطوعي وتكريس قيم التسامح والتعايش والتعاون لدى طلبة المرحلة الثانوية. وفي هذا الإطار استحدثت وزارة التربية والتعليم منهج المهارات الحياتية وعملت على تحديث وتطوير عدة مناهج أخرى، كما ركزت جهودها على تدريب المعلمين والتربويين على طرق تطبيق هذه المناهج الجديدة والمطورة وإبراز ما تتضمنه من قيم وطنية نبيلة. سيدي صاحب الجلالة، تحتفل وزارة التربية والتعليم اليوم بمختلف قطاعاتها بهذه الذكرى الوطنية الغالية، ويحدوها عظيم الفخر والاعتزاز بما تحقق في عهد جلالتكم الزاهر من إنجازات رائدة بفضل ما تولونه من رعاية سامية للعلم والتعليم ومنتسبيه. وانطلاقاً من توجيهات جلالتكم السديدة وفقاً لمبادرات ومشاريع الحكومة الموقرة برئاسة سيدي صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد رئيس مجلس الوزراء حفظه الله ورعاه، وعملاً بأحكام دستور مملكة البحرين وما تضمنه الميثاق من قيم ومبادئ نبيلة تكرس المساواة وتكافؤ الفرص، تعمل وزارة التربية والتعليم على توفير الخدمة التعليمية الجيدة وإتاحة الفرص لكل أبناء الوطن ومن ضمنهم ذوي الاحتياجات الخاصة، والتوسع في خدمات التعليم المبكر بما ينعكس إيجاباً على مستوى التحصيل العلمي لخريجي المؤسسات التعليمية في وطننا العزيز، ويتيح الفرص لجميع فئات المجتمع للاستفادة من أفضل الخدمات التعليمية. وفي الختام نسأل الله جلت قدرته أن يحفظ جلالتكم ويرعاكم، وأن يسدد على طريق الخير خطاكم، وأن يبقيكم ذخراً وسنداً لمملكة البحرين وشعبها المحب لجلالتكم، إنه سميع مجيب الدعاء. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
ربي سألتك قلباً فيه متسع للكون كي أودع البحرين داخله، وأعطني بعض ما ترويه أبحورها شعراً لها وكأني كنت قائله. وهب لي الحب يجثو تحت أرجلها كالبحر حتى أكون اليوم ساحله، وامنح لأذني لحن الحب تعزفه البحرين صبحاً لأصغي في المساء له. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة، إن طلبة مملكة البحرين من مختلف المدارس وتعبيراً عن الحب والامتنان والولاء الذي يحملونه في قلوبهم لجلالتكم، يقدمون هذا الأوبريت الفني، وهو من كلمات نخبة من شعراء المملكة ومن إنتاج وزارة التربية والتعليم.
After that, three poems were delivered by students and four musical performances took place.
سأرفع رأسي لهذا العلم
وأرفعه لجميع الأمم،
أقول لهم
إنني هاهنا بأرض الحضارة منذ القدم،
بلادي سأبني بساحاتها وفوق السواحل أو وسط يم،
صروحاً تفيء بأركانها، قلوباً تفيء بظل العلم،
قلوباً تفيء بظل العلم، وأبذل عمري لصون حماها،
وأوفي بعهدي وأرسي القيم،
وأكتب تاريخها في الفؤاد،
وفيه اتخذت مداد القلم، وأكتب تاريخها في الفؤاد، وفيه اتخذت مداد القلم.
إنني للعلم أسعى أبدا، وسنى القرآن عندي موردا، فهو خير وملاذ وهدى، وثمار العلم أجنيها غدا. يا حياتي يا ملاذي سكني، يا هنائي يا رجائي إنني،
يا حياتي يا ملاذي سكني، يا هنائي يا رجائي إنني،
لك أحيا في رضا يسعدني، لك أحيا في رضا يسعدني،
وطني أحيا على مر الزمن. إن تغنينا كثيرا للوطن، إن حميناه العوادي والمحن، إن حفظناه عزيزا دائما، وطني يحيا على مر الزمن.
سأغنيك بألحان الولاء وأحبك، داعيا ربا مجيبا للدعاء، وهو ربك إنني طوعك في كل زمان، رافع اسمك في كل مكان، ذاك حبك يا يا وطني.
تغنينا كثيرا
بالوطن،
حميناه العوادي والمحن، إن حفظناه عزيزا دائما وطني يحيا على مر الزمن.
على هالأرض نتلاقى نهر حب ونهر إبداع، حناجرنا لحن قاصة وخطواتنا هواه شراع.
من البحرين للعالم نسافر وننشر ثقافتنا، ونتقاسم محبتنا، ونخلي النجوم تباع.
من الماضي إلى الحاضر، زرعنا الفرحة حق باكر، سواحلنا أيادي حب تستقبل هوى النهام،
ونتنسم هوى الغواص في نخوة أهالينا مثل لهجة حرارة صيف، نمطر كل أغانينا.
دمجت أطفال في التعليم، شباب
خطيبك يا حمد يرفع الراس، شيخ الوفا والمرجلة والشهامة، مليكنا اللي ثبت الحكم والساس، ونعيش في ظله بأمن وسلامة. جلالته رمز التطور ونبراس، قالوا الكلام ووافي في كلامه، في يوم ميثاق الوطن أفرح الناس، وثبت لنا فخر وعز وكرامة. يا شيخنا يا شيخنا اللي في الطويلات نوماس، لك هامة تصعب على كل هامة، حنا دروع الوطن في حراس، كل المدن ويا القرى والمنامة، حنا ولانا يا وطن ما له قياس، في ظل ابو سلمان عالي مقامه.
عرضة البحر ما تنتخلى، قناد راس اللي يود المثايا،
عرضة البحر ما
Yeah.
وسرور. يا هلا وبراع الميثاق والدستار، أبو سلمان حامي الدار، عالي الشان باني نهضة الأوطان.
يا أبو سلمان، يا أبو سلمان، في عهدك تطورنا وخلينا الزمن يسمع منايرنا، تحدينا الصعب وياك وكل أرواحنا، وكل أرواحنا تفداك.
ومع الإصلاح والميثاق والدستور عرفنا، عرفنا قيمة الإنسان من هالنور، وتعاقدنا على الإخلاص مثل دانة في يد غواص. ويا البحرين، يا البحرين، خلينا العمر لتسور.
الشموخ والانتماء رمز الإباء.
حمدنا الوائلي المستنير، عاهلنا عنوان حب ونقاء، هما منشاه إنه القلب الكبير، عظيم الشأن حمد رمز الإباء.
بميثاق تفردنا به، تعلمنا به معنى العطاء،
وعاهلنا المعظم يرتقي بنا نحو التقدم.
حمادنا الوائلي المستنير عاهلنا عنوان حب ونقاء هما منشا إنه القلب الكبير عظيم الشأن حمد رمز الإباء
حمادنا الوائلي المستنير عاهلنا عنوان حب ونقاء هما منشا إنه القلب الكبير عظيم الشأن حمد رمز الإباء بميثاق تفردنا به تعلمنا به معنى العطاء وعاهلنا المعظم يرتقي بنا نحو التقدم والبناء هنا هنا هنا
هنا حيث الشموخ والانتماء
On the occasion, His Majesty the King expressed thanks and appreciation to all participants in the event and those who contributed to its success. His Majesty praised the lofty national meanings and sincere feelings included in the celebration, which confirmed the authentic national values on which generations of students were raised in schools through Education Ministry curricula and its students' activities. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received a cable congratulations from His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa on the anniversary of the National Action Charter. His Royal Highness pointed out that this occasion represents a pillar of national work and wide-ranging progress and prosperity. His Royal Highness took pride in the milestone hailing citizens' unity to achieve a better future for the kingdom and contribute to meeting national development goals in all fields. He affirmed that His Majesty the King's wise directives represent a roadmap for building a brighter present and future for Bahrain. He pledged to continue assuming all responsibilities to achieve His Majesty's visions and to build on the national achievements that the charter was based on, and to continue working according to its principles and values in implementation of the aspirations of His Majesty and continuing the path of development. His Majesty the King sent a cable of thanks in reply to His Royal Highness, expressing pride in His Royal Highness's congratulations on the occasion. His Majesty noted the charter represents a milestone in the modern national history, marking a new chapter of political life, partnership, economic and social development and democracy. He praised the efforts of His Royal Highness to achieve further development and progress through ambitious initiatives and projects that enhance Bahrain's standing on development indicators. His Majesty recalled the landmark achievements since the defining history moment that paved the way for the reform project. His Majesty praised His Royal Highness's role in the Blessed March from its early beginnings through chairing the committee in charge of activating the charter and setting visions and programs to achieve the goals enshrined in the covenants and the aspirations of the Bahraini society. He hailed His Royal Highness's continued efforts to achieve further progress at all levels through ambitious development initiatives, plans and projects. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received a cable of congratulations from Her Royal Highness, the wife of His Majesty the King and President of the Supreme Council for Women, Princess Sabika bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa, on the anniversary of the National Action Charter. Her Royal Highness praised a national milestone, which has deep historical significance, marking the beginning of the era of development achievements in the prosperous era of His Majesty the King. Her Royal Highness stressed renewing loyalty in implementing the visions of His Majesty the King, inspired by His Majesty's keenness for Bahraini women to have a prominent and effective role in national development. She pledged to His Majesty the King that Supreme Council for Women will remain translating His Majesty's aspirations in developing the role of women and integrating their needs in national development. His Majesty the King sent a cable of thanks in reply to Her Royal Highness, expressing pride in her congratulations on the occasion, which included the established principles, values, and constants agreed upon by the people of Bahrain, which remain a comprehensive and established national approach that aids national action. His Majesty hailed Bahraini women's honorable achievements thanks to the principles of the Charter, praising Her Royal Highness's role as SCW President and for her directives. His Majesty the King proudly recalled landmark achievements since the defining historic moment that paved the way for the reform project to restore the development of Bahrain. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received a cable of congratulations from National Guard Commander General His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Isa bin Salman Al-Khalifa on the anniversary of the National Action Charter, and on behalf of all National Guard members. His Highness Sheikh Mohammed affirmed that this occasion embodies the people's full support for His Majesty's reforms that mark the beginning of a prosperous era and a comprehensive development under His Majesty's leadership. His Highness wished His Majesty the King many happy returns and abundant health and happiness to continue Bahrain's development and civilizational journey. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received a cable of congratulations from Royal Court Affairs Minister His Highness Sheikh Ali bin Isa Al Khalifa on the anniversary of the National Action Charter. The minister stressed that the charter reflected the kingdom's development in various fields, embodying His Majesty the King's reform based on justice, freedom, and tolerance. His Highness affirmed that the charter established the foundations of the modern state with steady and solid steps and reflected His Majesty's wise visions to develop the kingdom for the benefit of all and fulfill the aspirations of the people of development and prosperity. He praised the achievements of the comprehensive development process that accompanied the prosperous era of His Majesty in various fields and achieved many national gains. His Highness prayed to Allah the Almighty to protect His Majesty and grant him good health and happiness to continue the process of progress and prosperity for the kingdom. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received a cable of congratulations from His Majesty's King's personal representative and President of the Supreme Council for Environment, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Hamad Al Khalifa, on the anniversary of the National Action Charter. His Highness expressed pride in the Kingdom's national development and achievements across all sectors under the directives of His Majesty the King. His Highness wished His Majesty the King abundant health and to Bahrain and its people further progress and prosperity under His Majesty's leadership. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received a cable of congratulations from the Special Representative of His Majesty the King, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, on the anniversary of the National Action Charter. His Highness affirmed that this occasion embodies the visions of the approach of the reform project of His Majesty the King. He added that the charter came with the consensus of the people of the kingdom, confirming their cohesion and firm belief in the wise leadership of His Majesty towards achieving their ambitions and aspirations in various areas of comprehensive development. His Highness wished His Majesty abundant health and happiness, and for Bahrain and its people, further progress and prosperity. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received a cable of congratulations from the BDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa on the anniversary of the National Action Charter and on behalf of all BDF members. The Commander-in-Chief stressed the nation's pride and support of this reform project thanks to His Majesty's wise vision. He affirmed that this occasion embodies the national will to build the present and future of the nation. He wished His Majesty many happy returns and abundant health and happiness. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa received a cable of congratulations from the Commander of the National Guard, His Highness General Sheikh Mohammed bin Isa Al Khalifa, on the anniversary of the endorsement of the National Action Charter. His Highness also congratulated His Royal Highness on behalf of the National Guard affiliates. His Highness emphasized that the charter, which was adopted unanimously by Bahraini citizens, will remain a beacon for the kingdom's progress and prosperity. His Highness wished His Royal Highness continued success in achieving the goals of the kingdom's comprehensive development led by His Majesty the King. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa received a cable of congratulations from the Minister of the Royal Court Affairs, His Highness Sheikh Ali bin Isa Al Khalifa, on the anniversary of the National Action Charter. His Highness expressed pride in the Kingdom's achievements thanks to the leadership of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and the support of His Royal Highness. His Highness wished His Royal Highness continued success in achieving the Kingdom's goals of the comprehensive development led by His Majesty the King. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa received a cable of congratulations from the personal representative of His Majesty the King and President of the Supreme Council for the Environment, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Hamad Al Khalifa, on the anniversary of the National Action Charter. His Highness expressed pride in the Kingdom's accomplishments, placing the Kingdom as a leading country thanks to the visions of His Majesty the King and the support of His Royal Highness. His Highness wished His Royal Highness success in further developing Bahrain to achieve the Kingdom's comprehensive development led by His Majesty the King. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa received a cable congratulations from the Special Representative of His Majesty the King, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, on the anniversary of the National Action Charter. His Highness stressed that this historic occasion embodies the vision of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, which is fully supported by Bahraini citizens. His Highness commended the vision of His Royal Highness and his support of various development paths, wishing further progress and prosperity to the kingdom and its people. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa received a cable congratulations from BDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa on the anniversary of the National Action Charter. Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed congratulated His Royal Highness on behalf of all BDF personnel. The Commander-in-Chief affirmed that the charter comes as a dedication to the wise vision of His Majesty the King to build a future of national constance and development with the support and follow-up of His Royal Highness. He wished His Royal Highness many happy returns. The Representatives Council Speaker Ahmed Limsalem stressed that the anniversary of the National Action Charter affirms the national support for the leadership and is considered a comprehensive national approval of the royal vision of the future of Bahrain. Limsalem indicated that the directives of His Majesty the King are established approach in the pillar of the national action for Team Bahrain in all fields under the leadership of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister. He stressed the parliamentary keenness to continue national work to achieve the royal aspirations through constructive cooperation between the legislative and executive authorities to serve the nation and the citizens. The Shura Council Chairman Ali Saleh affirmed that the National Action Charter is based on national constance, foundations, and civilizational principles. He added that the royal vision and the wise approach of His Majesty the King established the principles of these constants. He noted the keenness of the government to embody the principles of foundations stipulated in the charter and translate them into government initiatives and programs, praising the support of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister. Bahrain celebrates the anniversary of the issuance of the National Action Charter, which marked the beginning of the comprehensive development and sustainable development process in all sectors led by His Majesty the King, and was able to consolidate the foundations of modern democracy with the frameworks of the rule of law and institutions with the support of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister. On this occasion, the Kingdom recalls His Majesty the King's leadership of the national development process with wisdom and insightful vision that reformulated the political, social, and economic reality of Bahrain and achieved leadership for the Kingdom with the participation of its society. Member of the Shura Council Hale Ramzi said Bahrain witnessed qualitative developments under the leadership of His Majesty the King that led the democratic reforms following the inception of the National Action Charter. She also highlighted the vast success of women's representation in the fields of politics and development march.
Every 14th February, Bahrain proudly celebrates the National Action Charter and the developments that have been seen in the democratic reform, which is the project of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. Bahrain has really seen qualitative developments and benefits from the democratic reform in the sense of human rights, freedoms, equality, equal rights for all citizens without any discrimination on the basis of sex, religion, belief, or origin. And the core of the National Action Charter really is to have mutual acceptance, religion tolerance, and peaceful coexistence. And we have seen lots of achievements that Bahraini women have really able to score with this reform project.
And member of the Shura Council, Nancy Khadouri, affirmed that the National Action Charter signaled an era of reform and development for the Kingdom of Bahrain.
The 23rd anniversary of the National Action Charter marks an important occasion for the Kingdom of Bahrain, and I take the opportunity to congratulate our leadership and nation. The National Action Charter signaled an era of reform and development for our country, where we continue to witness legislative achievement. And of course, the National Action Charter is seen as a robust pillar of Bahrain's modern success in the political, economic, and social spheres. We look forward to further reform to bring about more transparency and accountability, and for continued cooperation between our legislative, executive, and judicial powers in accordance with the Constitution of the Kingdom of Bahrain.
The anniversary of the National Action Charter is an opportunity to recall the national support of His Majesty the King in voting on the Charter to develop the democratic process. More on this report.
The National Action Charter came as a pioneering idea in which all Bahraini people participated in. A draft committee of the National Action Charter was then formed to reach consensus and balance the Charter's outputs for the people. After the Charter was put to a public referendum, the high percentage of those who approved it was a result of the democracy and the belief of the people of Bahrain in the vision of His Majesty the King to develop the democratic experience. After voting on the Charter, His Majesty the King issued a decree forming a committee to activate the National Action Charter with the aim of reviewing all national laws and legislation and proposing the necessary amendments and mechanisms to implement the principles of the Charter. The committee was chaired by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, and as a result of this committee, the provisions of the Charter were codified in the amended Constitution of the Kingdom of Bahrain in 2002. The vote on the Charter represents an advanced model in building a state of law and institutions, which is a source of pride for all Bahraini citizens.
The National Action Charter Monument was built based on the directives of His Majesty the King to remain an everlasting symbol of patriotic stances of Bahrainis. More in this report.
In commemoration of the National Action Charter, His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa issued royal directives to establish a monument commemorating the names of all Bahrainis who voted on the Charter in confirmation of its importance in the contemporary history of Bahrain. The walls of the monuments document the name of more than 220,000 Bahrainis who voted on the Charter. The monument is dedicated to all those who played a role in building Bahrain's development in the past and present. It was inaugurated on February 14, 2010, and includes main exhibition halls that represent the past and present of Bahrain. The designs were prepared using artistic engineering with continuous movements and infinite dimensions, making the building an architectural and cultural landmark by all standards. The National Action Charter Monument constitutes a symbol that embodies the unity of the nation. It represents the unity between His Majesty the King and the people and reflects the national fundamentals on which the Bahraini citizens agree, as the Charter focuses on the values of unity, diversity, and respect for the other.
The Speaker of the Arab Parliament, Adel Assoumi, affirmed that the National Action Charter constituted a national experience in which the people of the kingdom chose their path towards democracy, development, prosperity. On the anniversary of the Charter, Assoumi affirmed that the Charter paved the way towards the start of the democratic process in the kingdom, established the rule of law and the concept of justice and human rights. He added that the occasion is an opportunity to emphasize the achievements made by the kingdom in various fields. The fraternal meeting between His Majesty the King and His Highness the Emir of Kuwait embodied the depth of the established relations between the two brotherly countries. More on this report. His Highness the Emir of Kuwait paid a visit to the Kingdom of Bahrain and was received by His Majesty the King upon his arrival. The visit of His Highness the Emir is an embodiment of the strong and established relations between the two countries and confirms the role played by the honorable leaders and ancestors in order to continue developing the close fraternal relations. Strengthening cooperation paths and joint work in all fields was one of the most prominent topics that the visit focused on. The situation in the region and the overall regional and international developments were also discussed, especially the situation in Palestine and the occupied Arab territories, and the necessity of reaching comprehensive political solution to the Yemeni crisis, in addition to emphasizing the importance of respecting the principle of state sovereignty. The upcoming Arab Summit in its 33rd regular session, which will be held in the capital Manama on May 16th, was on the agenda of the discussions, as the two sides expressed hope that the summit will make a real contribution to strengthening joint Arab action. The success of the Joint Security Committee meeting between the two countries in July 2023 and the notable achievements made by the joint Gulf cooperation process were also praised. The two sides also stressed that the Durra field is joint ownership between Kuwait and Saudi Arabia only, and the importance of maintaining the security and stability of the Red Sea region and respecting the right of maritime navigation.
On May 30, 1949, the ruler of Kuwait, Sheikh Ahmed al-Jaber al-Sabah, visited Bahrain, where he was received by the ruler of Bahrain, Sheikh Salman bin Hamad al-Khalifa. On November 5, 1949, the ruler of Bahrain, Sheikh Salman bin Hamad al-Khalifa, arrived in Kuwait, where he was received by the Emir of Kuwait, Sheikh Ahmed Salman bin al-Jaber al-Sabah. On November 9, 1949, this photo was taken during a celebration held by the health department to celebrate the ruler of Bahrain at the Emiri Hospital. On September 13, 1952, the ruler of Bahrain, Sheikh Salman bin Hamad al-Khalifa, visited Kuwait and was received by the ruler of Kuwait, Sheikh Abdullah Salim al-Sabah. On May 7, 1966, His Highness Sheikh Sabah al-Salim al-Sabah made an official visit to Bahrain after assuming the reins of government in Kuwait. On May 25, 1970, His Majesty the King of Bahrain, the Crown Prince of Bahrain at the time, made the first official visit to Kuwait at the invitation of the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, His Highness Sheikh Jaber al-Ahmed al-Jaber al-Sabah. On May 26, 1970, His Majesty the King of Bahrain, the Crown Prince of Bahrain at the time, visited the 15th Brigade accompanied by Lieutenant General Sheikh Mubarak al-Abdullah al-Jaber al-Sabah and senior leaders of the Kuwaiti Army. On March 14, 1974, His Majesty the King, the Crown Prince of Bahrain at the time, visited Kuwait and was received by Sheikh Sabah al-Ahmed al-Jaber al-Sabah, the Kuwaiti Foreign Minister at the time. On December 17, 1974, His Majesty the King, the Crown Prince of Bahrain at the time, visited Kuwait and met with its Emir, His Highness Sheikh Sabah al-Salim al-Sabah, where he received him at Seif Palace. On December 13, 1978, His Majesty the King, the Crown Prince of Bahrain at the time, visited Kuwait, during which he met with His Highness Sheikh Sa'ad al-Abdullah al-Salim al-Sabah, the Crown Prince and Prime Minister of Kuwait.
The Bahrain Team for Royal Hospitality announced the graduation of the first batch of its program and the participation completed intensive training in hospitality in cooperation with the Four Seasons. The team, which was formed under Royal Director, stated that the graduation coincided with the visit of His Highness the Emir of Kuwait to Bahrain, where the team provided hospitality services in accordance with the highest international standards and authentic Bahraini hospitality. By a royal order from His Majesty the King to establish a Bahrain team for royal hospitality, we reached the concerned bodies to form the team, and we appointed the Four Seasons to assume the responsibilities of the team. The team successfully served His Majesty the King during the visit of His Highness the Emir of Kuwait and his accompanying delegation.
As the general manager of the Four Seasons Hotel Bahrain Bay, my team and I are extremely honored to have the vision of His Majesty the King of Bahrain to train the next generation of Bahraini hospitality talent. Over the past 6 months, the Royal Bahraini hospitality team have been working very hard in all aspects of hotel operations, including service to our guests. And today it culminated in them going to the Royal Palace for the official visit of the Emir of Kuwait. And the team did an outstanding job, and we look forward to further development and further growth of their talent over the coming months ahead.
I am proud to have enrolled in this program and thankful to have succeeded in it, which is to serve His Majesty the King and His Majesty's guests. I encourage all Bahrainis to participate in this program to serve His Majesty, and I hope it motivates others. We were trained in many services that qualify us to be fully ready in a short time. The team and I have been able to provide excellent service.
Alhamdulillah, We are thankful to have been able to serve His Majesty the King and His Majesty's distinguished guests. The organizers of the project spared no efforts in teaching us authentic Bahraini customs and traditions to apply while serving His Majesty and His guests. We are very happy and proud to have met His Majesty and to have served His Majesty and His guests.
The competitions of the Ministry of Interior 2024 Challenger Tennis Tournament held at the General Security Officers Club in Glaibiya continue from February 11th to the 17th. More on this report.
The competitions of the Ministry of Interior Bahrain Tennis Challenger Tournament held at the General Security Officers Club in Glaibiya continue from February the 11th to the 17th. The tournament is organized and supervised by the General Security Sports Union and is known for its exceptional level characterized by sportsmanship, fair competition and the high-level skills of the participating players. Tennis players have expressed their satisfaction with their first visit to the Kingdom of Bahrain and praised the excellent organization of the tournament in all aspects.
It feels good to play here in Bahrain. It's an Arab country, so it always feels really good for the Arab players. We don't have many events, so it's nice to be here, and I hope my run will be really long this week. There is not many Arab players on tour. I think there is maybe three or four that are in the top 500. 99% of the year I play outside of the Arab world. So it feels really nice to be playing in Bahrain or in an Arab world in general. We feel at home. We feel there is much more support from the tournament, from the crowd. So it's really nice. It's an advantage we have when we have these tournaments. But most of the players, they have so many more tournaments in their region, so it's an advantage to them. So I'm happy we are starting to have more tournaments in the Arab world, and hopefully we can also encourage and support the Arab players this way.
I'm happy. First time here in Bahrain, so good weather.
The weather's nice.
Weather is wise, and happy about my first round. Well, it's my first tournament after the injury, so I'm coming from the cold to the hot weather, so I'm happy. You know, I have another opportunity to play some points that what I need at the moment, so really looking forward.
Okay.
Well, it depends. I mean, this sport is nice, but it's at the same time it's difficult. So for the first time, I think with every sport, it is the first word that is coming on my mind is enjoy.
On the third day of the Ministry of Interior Bahrain Tennis Challenger Tournament, there was intense competition among the players in the round of 32. The top-seeded Australian player Christopher O'Connell was eliminated after losing to British player Billy Harris with a score of 6-7, as O'Connell withdrew from the match due to injury. Furthermore, on Wednesday there will be 8 matches in the round of 16 in the singles category and 8 matches in the doubles category. Tennis players are loving their first time in Bahrain and are feeling like tennis royalty. Reporting for Bahrain International Television, Safiya Al-Hajri.